Hi friends, Angular 17 has been released. Usually when there is a new version of Angular, only then I will install the N-1 version in my machine. That means, only when the Angular 16 was released, I upgraded my Angular from 14 to 15. But this time, I have installed Angular 17 to see what has been introduced. I have already upgraded my Node.js version and I have installed Angular version 17. You can see the version here. Let me create a new application using CLI. Let's see how it is. Which stylesheet format would you like to use? I always choose SCSS. But I remember till 16, it used to ask whether we need to add routing or not. Okay, let me choose SCSS. Do you want to enable server-side rendering, SSR, and static-site generation, SSG, or pre-rendering? Server-side rendering and pre-rendering are interesting concepts. We will see that in a separate video. Now let me choose no. Okay, application is getting created. It is created. Before I start the application, let me open this in VS Code and see the files once. Okay, this is good. Where is the app module? Okay, Angular 17 is creating the standalone component by default. Goodbye to ng module. Our routes are separated in an app routes file. And there is an app config file in which the routes are provided using something called provide router from Angular router. And in our main.ts, this app config is used while bootstrapping the application. Let's start our server. Wow, it is so quick. And smaller bundles. Let's preview. Nice, it's completely changed. You can see the new logo here. Angular is getting improved release by release. I'm very happy about that. Okay friends, we will dig more deeper into the new features introduced in upcoming videos. Thank you, bye.